Hello everyone, Alex here from warnoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can edit a message as well as how to react to a message. So throughout this tutorial we're going to be creating a utility that will allow us to send a first message. If we look into our Discord server right here, the warnoffkeys Discord, if we look in rules and info, this is an example. So people can actually type in here, and this is a message that has been edited. So whenever I want to update the rules, I can then just change the text and restart the bot, and then the rules will be updated automatically. And also we're going to automatically be adding roles, such as right here. So to get started, if we go back to Visual Studio Code, I have a basic project here. It doesn't have much. However, if you do want to clone this, a link to the GitHub repository will be in the video description. And to get started, we're going to make a new file. This will be called first-message.js. We're going to export a function that'll contain a client, the ID for the text channel, the actual text, that'll be the message itself, and an optional list of reactions. So by default, that'll be an empty array. This actually has to be an asynchronous function because the first thing we're going to do is we're going to get the channel. So await client.channels.fetch, we want to get the ID. Now we want to actually get the messages from the channel. So we can say channel.messages.fetch, and this returns a promise, so we can use .then. And we're going to get a messages object. So the first thing we want to do here is we want to see if a message already exists, because if a message exists, then we just want to edit the existing message. Otherwise, we want to send a new message. So if messages.size is exactly equal to 0, we are going to send a new message. Otherwise, we are going to edit the existing message. So to send a message, this is fairly simple. We're going to say channel.send with the text. And then we're going to have .then, which is going to be a promise. And this is going to return the actual message. Now in here is where we're going to actually add the reaction. So I'm going to actually create another function. This will be called addReactions. And this will have the message and the reactions. And this is going to be a recursive function. I'm going to say message.react, reactions index 0, and then reactions.shift, which will remove the 0 index and then move everything to the left. And so eventually this will become an empty array. So we want to say if reactions.length is greater than 0, we want to set a timeout, and this will just be calling the addReactions method again, message and reactions. And we want to wait around 750 milliseconds. The reason for this is that if you do this too quickly, sometimes you'll see different reactions being added in different orders. And if your use case doesn't require the reactions to be in a specific order, then you don't have to worry about this. You can just call it immediately. However, frequently I like them to be in a very specific order. And so I want to add a delay to ensure that it actually happens in that exact order. So now inside of the .then from the .send promise, we can access the message and we can say add reactions. We can pass in the message and the reactions. So if we save this, when we go to our index.js file, we first have to import this file. So constant first message equals require first message. Then we're going to call this method. So this requires the client, an ID, which we'll get in a second, the text of hello world, and an array. So to get the ID, you have to have developer mode enabled on your Discord account, and you can right click on the channel you want and click on copy ID. Now to get the actual reactions, we can go to a website. This is called emojipedia.org. The link to this will be in the description. If we search up a reaction such as fire right here, we can go back and we can paste it in here. If we save this and we run our bot with node index.js, okay, so I realize I had a typo here. So once we fix that and we restart the bot, we see the client is ready. If we go back, we see hello world, and then we see the actual reaction right here. So now what we want to do is we want to edit every other message in the channel. Typically, this makes sense if you have no actual write permissions to the channel, so no one can send messages. So we're going to loop through all of the messages, and then we are going to console log what the message contains. If we restart our bot, we see some information here. If we scroll up, we see that the zero index is an ID, and the first index is an actual message object, which is what we want to gain access to. So we can say message index1.edit. We can pass in the text. And then we can also say add reactions, message index1, and then reactions. So if we save this and we stop the bot. If we go over to our index file, we see hello world, which is what we currently see as the message, and we only have one fire emoji. If we add 3 exclamation points and we add another emoji, such as a watermelon, if we copy this and we paste it in here and we save this, we open up Discord and we start our bot. We then see it adds 3 exclamation points and adds the watermelon reaction. So everything seems to be working, and that is how you're going to send a message, edit a message, as well as react to a message. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the Warnoff Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description.